Hi, I'm Donovan Marsh. I'm director of iNumber Jozi Gold, and I am here with
Sdumo Mtshali, who plays Chilingobo,
and Presley Chweneyagae, who plays Shoes.
I'm glad you know who you play. We're going to be looking at some really interesting shots from the film and discussing what went into making them. This is the opening of the film. We wanted something really, really sexy to introduce our really sexy guy over here. And so we set up a series of very, very complicated shots up on Nelson Mandela Bridge. And what's so interesting about that sequence is there's actually four different cameras being used there. We're starting with a drone that did this incredible movement all up and around the bridge, and Sdumo was driving. We had to get the timing exactly right, coming into the car.
But what I love about it is just how it's not like your normal drone shots, how they establish the vibe, the mood, the feeling, the danger. I just love how that all ensemble came in nicely.
Crossing over to some really beautiful classic cameras on 14 millimeter and wider lenses, getting those beautiful close-ups of the various different things. And then we're actually using a cell phone because we have to do a shot that goes all the way around into your button and taking us into the command vehicle. And we actually found the best camera to do that was a cell phone because it was the only thing I could do that sweep with. I couldn't get a big camera to sweep. So the tiny little cell phone on its wide lens, I was able to sweep it and go right into your button there. So that's an in-camera effect.
The Mandela Bridge.
I want to do something quite fun there. So we start off with this Casper Nyovest song, these incredible shots. And so it's quite stylistic, you know, it's very beautiful. And I'm setting up the mood and the style. And then I wanted to transition from that once we go into the van into something that shows the union between these two characters. And this is these guys kind of completing each other's sentences through this rap. Tell us about the rap.
The rap, I mean, I'm a lyricist myself, you know, but, you know, the rap was quite tricky. But I must say that at least Casper Nyovest is my homeboy.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So at least it was a part, and there and there, you know, it was a little bit more easier.
I see you, sir.
It's possibly the most ambitious shot in the whole film is that drone shot that starts in the van with you and exits the van, goes up over the building, right through the entire interior. I should have taken a whole day to film just that one shot. I kind of knew I probably needed a whole day to coordinate all of that, and some very tricky and dangerous drone moves. And you'll notice that drone's passing very, very close to people, and it's obviously a danger. But given the schedule and the way we did, I actually only had half a day to shoot it, and it was very hard to get right. And this was the last take I did, and the sun was setting, and I wasn't actually sure if I was going to get it. That's how tough it was, and to get the drone coordinating with the people was just incredibly tough. Because not only were we flying that flight path, we were in different lighting conditions. So we're in outside, which is very bright and it's a certain color temperature. Then suddenly inside, it's dark, different color temperature. And so we actually have to pull the iris and do some very clever grading to try and pull the whole thing together. But in the end, actually, it's a really beautiful shot. It works well, it takes you into the environment, lets you know where you are. It sets up the first big set piece, which is going to be this guy going in and nailing that hyena man. I wanted to have a real hyena, but then Presley probably wouldn't have a hand left because he's the one who had to actually interact with it. But believe it or not, I actually thought I want to get a real hyena, and I actually went and I looked at real hyenas, and it quickly became apparent that was not going to be possible. So we had this big green, and it looked terrible, but to stand in for the hyena. But then I had to rely on these two guys to act like there was a real hyena there. And that, I mean, that's actually quite tough. How do you approach acting with something that's not actually physically there?
I think it was very important for me to also try and, you know, extend my imagination to a certain point and, you know, watch a lot of documentaries that have to deal with animals just to know their behavior. But it's always tricky, you know, when you're looking at this tennis ball or this puppet and you are hearing Donovan's voice from somewhere else by the VT saying, now it's approaching. And you feel like looking at him, but you're still looking at the tennis ball. It's moving faster now.
I kept screaming at you to be more afraid. Be more afraid.
There.
This is tennis ball.
The tennis ball.
Thank you so much for this
process. We're looking forward to this thing coming out.
Thank you to our director and writer, Don, for always making it fun, for always making us feel like we're working on a project that is on a global scale,
yeah,
of which I really believe this project is. And our audience should enjoy it.